It's probably fair to say that proponents of green energy have been seeing red since Governor Scott Walker took office. In just a few short weeks, Walker has killed high-speed rail and a biomass power plant in Madison. He's proposed development of some small wetlands and offered new wind turbine siting rules that some say will virtually shut down the state's wind energy industry. The question is, what, if any, consequences will these decisions have on economic development in Wisconsin? Joining us now is Democratic State Representative Brett Hulsey of Madison, a former Sierra Club leader who is at our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. Representative, thanks very much for being with us today. And let's begin with a more general question. The new governor, the new Republican legislature, say they've been spending time trying to improve the state's business climate. How would you characterize what's happened in the last month?
What Governor Walker and the lobbyists for the extreme right have done is given us a snow job that's created no job. They just killed another 300 jobs by running off Bass Pro Shop by giving the developer a dirty deal. So there's been no jobs created so far.
You claimed in a press release last week that, in fact, the Walker administration and the Republican legislature has cost the state 6,300 jobs. Where do you come up with that number?
Well, the Legislative Reference Bureau estimated we would have had 5,500 jobs had Governor Walker not given those train jobs to Illinois and other states. And then by killing the biomass plant, that killed between 800 and 1,000 jobs. So that's up to 6,300 jobs so far.
Now, of course, he would counter by saying that there are long-term costs, public costs, associated with each of those projects, whether it's high-speed rail, you have to maintain the system. That's on the backs of taxpayers. The same thing for the biomass power plant in Madison, that he could do that in a cheaper way. What do you say to that?
Right. For instance, those 5,500 train jobs, Madison and Milwaukee were willing to help pay the operating costs, which is only a few million dollars. You don't look an $800 million federal gift horse in the mouth and say, we're not willing to spend a few million to maintain it.
I want to have you address this issue of whether or not the state is a welcoming place for green energy jobs. You're a big proponent of clean energy, green jobs. Do you think that if you were starting a green energy business that you would come to Wisconsin or that you would look at Wisconsin?
I run a green energy business right now with my consulting business, and I can tell you everyone I talk to is scared to death. Walker wants to do the Clean Energy Jobs Killing Act by running off the wind energy with the most restrictive regulations in the nation.
I'm not a spokesperson for Scott Walker, obviously, but I think his argument would be, shouldn't all businesses play on the same level playing field? Why should we be giving preferential treatment, for instance, to green energy companies? What is your response to that?
Wisconsin doesn't make any, we don't have any coal, natural gas, or oil. We spend about $16 billion importing our energy needs. That's a loss of 400,000 jobs. So everything we can do to increase efficiency, create clean energy, creates jobs here. Scott Walker and the extreme right and the lobbyists are killing those jobs.
A bottom line in this discussion, though, is what can Democrats or people who favor green jobs, what can they realistically do? Because you simply don't have the numbers in the legislature, and you won't have them for some time.
We don't have the votes right now, you're right, and the extreme right and the lobbyists are totally in control. But people can call their members, their assembly members and senators, and say, we want real jobs, clean jobs now, we don't want a snow job.
And just for the record, when you say extreme right, who are you referring to?
I'm talking about lobbyists for the most extreme interests. For instance, wind energy groups that have been discredited by the facts. We had a bipartisan wind siting bill passed last year, but they want to bring that forward and kill over 1,000 wind energy jobs in Wisconsin.
Do you think, as some have suggested, that the wind energy industry in this state will be basically crippled by these new setback restrictions that we're talking about?
It'll be killed deader than a doornail.
Do you think that'll be a lost opportunity for the state?
Right, and that's what the wind energy executives have said. They said they want to work here. Many of them live here, but if we pass these job-killing rules, Those jobs will move to Illinois, Iowa, Minnesota, and other states.
Final question. The governor said none of this should come as a surprise to anyone who watched him during the campaign. Does any of this come as a surprise to you?
Well, when the voters went to the polls in November, they did not vote for this extreme job-killing agenda. They wanted to move Wisconsin forward. Scott Walker on the extreme right wants to take us backwards, and that's heading in the wrong direction.
State Representative Brett Hulsey of Madison, we appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you, Mike.
Well, we don't want to spoil anyone's fun on this Super Sunday, but it is possible we could see an NFL lockout later this year. What's in dispute and how it could affect the game we all love? That's next on Upfront.